You're super excited because your dog, cat, or ferret is now enjoying their new raw food. But after a few weeks, you start to notice they're regressing or seeming picky with parts that just a few weeks ago they were enthusiastically eating. Or maybe they've been picking and choosing parts and now they're just simply refusing everything. This isn't completely unusual to see, but it can certainly be frustrating when you have to end up throwing out perfectly good raw food. During this phase, it's easy for owners to think that they just don't like raw food and should switch back to their old food. But this may not be the case at all. Often, the answer is a simple fix and has absolutely nothing to do with the fact that they don't like their food anymore. Of course, before moving forward, you want to make sure that the reason that they aren't eating isn't caused by a health issue. A few things that will discourage your pet from eating can be a fractured tooth, gingivitis, GI upset, an infection, pain in a certain area, liver or kidney problems, or even cancer. Fortunately though, the more serious issues will almost always have other symptoms associated with it, like a fever, diarrhea, constantly drinking, or seeming painful. So if your pet is acting normal but just not wanting to eat the food that's right in front of them, it probably isn't too serious. Of course, always seek a veterinarian if you're worried. If it's not a health-related issue, here are some ways to help your pet get back on track with eating their raw meal. Number 1, switch up the protein sources. When you switch your pet to raw, you're probably only feeding 1-2 protein sources in the beginning. This is totally fine to do, as you don't want to introduce too many things too fast. But this may also come with a negative, and that is your pet getting bored. There have been times where I was low on protein sources, and Tangy would straight up walk away from the plate because he was getting sick of only beef and chicken. Once I got my hands on another protein source, he happily ate the entire meal. It wasn't that he disliked beef or chicken, he just didn't want a whole meal of only that. Spoiled cat. Number 2, feed the meal semi-frozen. When it comes to things like organ meats or even some muscle meats that have an odd texture or strong flavor, it may become off-putting after the first few novel times trying it. When Matsu was around 6 months of age, his food intake started to regress a lot more than I felt comfortable with. I noticed that he left his organ meats and some muscle meats at times, so I had to figure something out quickly. I tried grinding them, but that only worked half of the time, so I then started freezing the individual pieces of meats and offering it to him like a treat. Because freezing masked the strong flavor and firmed the texture, it became much more appealing to him. I do want to note though that while this is an effective way to get dogs used to smells and textures, it's not so effective or encouraged to do for cats and ferrets. Number 3, make sure it hasn't gone bad. I have received many messages in the past from owners who are at a loss because their pet is turning up their nose at their food. They ate the same parts just a few weeks ago after their past meal prep. So to the owner, nothing has changed. But this is where the problem may actually lie. Raw meat won't stay good for very long if it's not frozen. If a package of raw meat was thawed for a few days during prep, then packed back up and refroze, then thawed again for the next week's prep, the chances of it spoiling are much higher. Many times you can tell because it will have a rotten odor to it, or it may feel sticky and slimy. But even if it doesn't yet, odds are your pet will still notice. So if you know the meat you're feeding isn't fresh and your pet is turning their nose up at it, there is a chance it's going bad and no longer appealing anymore. In times like this, prepping a few fresh meals may be worth trying to see if that's actually what the issue is. If they eat this raw meal just fine, toss the other meals that have most likely gone bad. Bonus tip! If you've exhausted all of these tips and nothing has worked, the final thing you can try is sprinkling something tasty on top. Some owners add in juice from sardine cans, while others pour over some bone broth. These are fine toppers, but another nutritious and tasty option is sprinkling nutritional yeast. This is a deactivated yeast that's loaded with natural B vitamins and has a cheesy taste that cats and dogs love. It's important to always remember that while it's good to keep at it, you should never starve your pets, especially if they're young or have health ailments that require eating often. I have a bunch of other tips you can try that are usually reserved for pets that are just transitioning, but sometimes regression happens and you have to start from the beginning again. Watch these videos to learn more.